99.7 DJX, the Ben Davis and Kelly K Show podcast. Turn it up. On demand.
We give you setting the bar stories so you can look back on this moment and say, you know what, regardless of what happens in my life today, at least that didn't happen to me.
Yeah, you know what? You can still look at your life as a success compared to this.
Yeah, this is kind of a love story, kind of a setting the bar story. Some people may be moved to feel some compassion for Addie. Some may be like, nope. So we'll get to it, setting the bar. If you can manage to make it through the day without falling in love with a chimpanzee to the point where the zoo literally has to restrict your contact with the animal, you're doing okay.
Oh, wow. So the object of her affection is a literal monkey?
The chimpanzee's name is Cheetah.
Sorry, Cheetah.
Mm-hmm.
And got it.
He arrived in this Antwerp zoo there in Belgium 30 years ago. So,
oh, wow.
Yeah, he's an older guy, right?
Okay.
So, but
been around the block for a while.
Addie has been visiting Cheetah for just about every week for the past 4 years. And she has developed quite a close bond with the animal. She says, I love that animal. He loves me. I haven't got anything else. Why? Oh, I know. And then she says, we're having an affair. I'll just say.
I feel like there's limits.
So yes, the affairs she's talking about are blowing kisses and waving to each other from opposite sides of the glass.
It's an affair of the heart. Yes.
Right.
Yeah.
So the zoo was like, this doesn't seem like a very healthy relationship. And said, you know what? It's starting to negatively impact Cheetah and his ability to relate to and be accepted by the other chimpanzees there at the zoo.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Do you know what that tells me? That tells me Cheetah loves her back. I'm just saying. I'm just saying.
And there were some female chimpanzees in there going, who's that?
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Now listen, I have another question. Is mm-hmm. she paying every time she goes to the zoo for her visit? Because if so, it sounds like the zoo is profiting quite heavily from her love affair. I'm just saying.
So that really makes me think, I wonder what it would sound like if.
Oh, no, 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 sir. No, sir. Nope, nope. No.
A just quick Google search.
No. No, sir. I'm not going to. No.
Just. Okay. Okay. That's just a little.
No.
Little hit it and quit it there. Some
no.
chimpanzees making sweet, passionate love there. All
oh,
right.
Oh, God. No. No, no, no.
So, again, setting the bar. This is setting the bar. All right. And I realize humans and chimpanzees are not that far apart in the whole evolution chain, but
this is a bit of an impossible relationship, and for that, I think it's best for her well-being, well, and for his, and for the female chimpanzees who are getting overlooked.
Right, exactly.
Maybe she needs to look elsewhere. And I know breaking up is hard.
It is,
and she's obviously heartbroken.
Absolutely.
But hoping that she'll get more out of a relationship
with a
human that's exactly
with a
that's
human.
Not yeah. living in a zoo.
Right.
Yeah.
All right. So again, setting the bar. If you can manage to make it through the day without falling in love with the chimpanzee to the point where the zoo literally has to restrict your contact with the animal, you're doing okay.
Wow.